Almost 8 months later, Catherine Rowe still has a hard time getting on the bus.
I often let four buses go by because I can't get on a double-decker.
She's been diagnosed with PTSD and only rides single-level buses now. Even then, she has her moments.
If there's a bump or, you know, a mean swerve that might remind me, even if I'm reading, like, it'll just take me out of the reality and I'll just be like, boom, right back. And
Rose was sitting on the upper deck of the bus that day when it smashed into an overhang of a transit shelter.
And it tore through a bus like butter, like a knife through hot butter. Like, it was, it's just shocking.
Three passengers died, 23 were taken to hospital.
It was a very traumatic incident for our community.
Today, police announced the bus driver is now charged with three counts of dangerous driving causing death and 35 charges of dangerous driving causing bodily harm, to include all psychological and physical injuries.
It led an exhaustive investigation that included technical aspects, that included reconstruction, that included, as I indicated, interviewing of about 100 different people, some involved, some witnesses.
The driver, 42-year-old Asatu Diallo, had been on the job for less than a year and was involved in another crash between two buses just a month earlier. That raised questions about how the city trains and vets drivers, but today police found the city of Ottawa bears no criminal responsibility.
At least we're moving forward, I guess. I don't know that it brings any comfort the way it, maybe if it had just been road conditions that caused the accident. And I'm feeling for the families of the deceased and the badly injured as well at this point, because this can't provide them with much comfort either.
Rose is part of a class action lawsuit against the city. Her hope that this tragedy can serve as a lesson.
This has to be about change. This can't happen again.
The driver is expected to appear in court in September. Ashley Burke, CBC News, Ottawa.